Hello, my name is Veda Zuponcic. I'm a pianist and I'm a professor of music at Rowan University. Rachmaninoff's legacy is one of having been able to capture essential emotions. It's a pleasure to work, really it is, on such music. It all feels wonderful. He was a great pianist and he wrote pianistically, of course. His very special hand, none of us have it exactly, but it feels good to practice Rachmaninoff. And it's not a frustration, it's just the work that we have to do to bring it up to something like a performance level. You can't ever expect perfection from yourself. You really can't. There are just too many notes. Too much is going on. Something's going to miss, you know. We can learn a Mozart sonata and it can be absolutely note perfect from beginning to end. And you can come back to it 20 years later and it's pretty much in the same condition. But with Rachmaninoff, because you can have literally 5-6 different things going on at the same time, so much counterpoint, so many notes in every finger, that you don't retain it quite so well. You think you know what's going on in the middle voice, but guess what? You're losing the bass line or you're losing something else. Your mind has to be always reminded, your ears have to be reminded about what the notes are. So when you come back to something, it's a slow slog to make sure that it's all right again. I think that everybody has been tuned into Rachmaninoff melodies, Rachmaninoff harmonies, and it speaks to people, and it will always speak to people because it's really raw emotion more than you can say about lots of other composers.